Welcome back to Vikings Game Plan, courtesy of our friends at DraftKings. We have a daily fantasy recommendation. His name, Adam Thielen. Winning formula time, Ron Johnson, Vikings Game Day Live on Fox 9. Wobby from Vikings.com. Quickly, Adam Thielen for the DraftKings Daily Fantasy Bit. Good numbers, right?
No one has more catches or receiving yards than Adam Thielen in the last three NFL weeks going back to last season. Remember, he had 200 yards against the Packers in Week 16.
We have some very pressing topics to address into this Vikings-Pittsburgh Steelers game. But first, Steelers helmet. Logo on one side, no logo on the other. Let's go here. Do you love this helmet or not?
I do. I grew up with it. My dad was a Steeler, so yeah. I grew up with that helmet in the house.
What about you?
It's ugly. I don't want to see any of it. I want Eric Kendricks to knock the logo off those helmets on Sunday.
The Minnesota Vikings just defeated the New Orleans Saints and did a very good job against Hall of Famer-to-be Drew Brees. Got another one this week. Big Ben Roethlisberger. Tougher quarterback with whom to deal. Brees or Roethlisberger?
I'm going to go Roethlisberger. He's big. He's hard to bring down. It's going to take a couple guys to hit him. He's not the guy that's going to run, but Drew Brees looked pedestrian. And I know it's the Vikings defense that made him look pedestrian, but I like Big Ben.
Drew Brees is going to have maybe every passing record there is to have when he's done playing.
Yeah.
He's approaching the yardage record. I think it's 5,000 some yards he needs. Probably won't get it this year. Should get it next year.
Yeah.
Both guys Hall of Famers. Can't go wrong either way. Different styles of play. Drew is the more traditional type of quarterback. I'd go with him.
And both guys Super Bowl champions. Big Ben has won two. Brees, former Super Bowl MVP. Now, with Ben Roethlisberger, you have wide receiver Antonio Brown. You also have good pass-catching running back Le'Veon Bell. Which one is more important to stop and why, Bell or Brown?
I think it's the same formula as last week, guys. Slow the running game down and keep the opposition behind the chains. That's what the Vikings did against the Saints. No Saints rusher had more than 20 yards. That's a big reason why Mike Zimmer's defense was able to slow down Drew Brees. You want to slow down Big Ben, you got to stop Le'Veon Bell first.
You got an opinion?
I'd say Antonio Brown. I like the take, but Antonio Brown, 22 targets in the red zone last year. This past game, Le'Veon Bell had 35 yards rushing. It was against the Cleveland Browns.
We are splitting hairs here. Both of those guys, outstanding players. Oh, yeah.
Now for the Minnesota Vikings, speaking of outstanding players, Sam Bradford, maybe with the best game of his career in that Monday night game against the New Orleans Saints. I mean, seriously, the yards per attempt at 10.8, yes. Dalvin Cook also had a spectacular debut. So when it comes to this game, Ron, which player, Bradford or Cook, do you think will have tougher sledding?
Sam Bradford. In that 3-4 defense, you have to get the guys lined up. If you do not have your guys lined up and you don't figure out who the Mike backer is right away, it's going to be a long day. And we know what the Watt brothers can do, and TJ's just as good. Well, not just as good, but he's getting there as good as JJ. So I say Sam Bradford has a tougher sled against the Steelers.
I love disagreeing with Ron, but I like being right more, and I think Ron is right.
And you do a good job with both.
Yeah, well, thank you, Paul. I mean, we're talking about a Pittsburgh Steelers defense that wasn't even at home. They were on the road last week, and they got to DeShone Kizer seven times and picked him off once. Sam Bradford did not see that quality of pass rush against the Saints. He will see it on Sunday in Pittsburgh, so I think it's a tougher sled for Bradford than it is for Cook.
When you watch DeShone Kizer hold the ball, make bad decisions, he's a rookie. I mean, it's going to happen. I mean, seriously, I just don't feel like Bradford's going to be the same guy.
No, you're right.
No, not at all.
And this was the criticism of the passing offense last season, was that Bradford got rid of the ball too quickly, short passing game. On the road in Pittsburgh against that crowd, that's probably the way to do it, to get rid of the ball quickly. And you jettison maybe some of the 5- and 7-step drops in the deep passing game to just get rid of the ball and not be facing second and third.
And at Heinz Field, we know the Steelers don't want to play catch-up.
Right.
No doubt. I mean, you have to relish the moment each and every time you get the opportunity to go there, for sure. Bradford with a lot of mustard on his passes. All right, let's go outside of the box here momentarily to close Vikings game plan. Green Bay is at Atlanta, Sunday night football. Green Bay or Atlanta, and why?
If I was Lee Corso, I'd put a cheese head on. Packers. they look so good against the Seattle Seahawks.
Yeah.
The Bears, Falcons, the Bears are without Kevin White. They're without their others.
Kevin White's a game changer.
It's bad.
You're not seeing it clearly.
No, he's not.
Okay, last
these are glasses.
But he's new to the show. It's okay.
What is special about this game with the Falcons and the Packers? The Falcons are opening up their new stadium against the Green Bay Packers. How'd that work for Green Bay last year? Opened up U.S. Bank Stadium, lost. Gonna happen again.
Great job. All right. Great job. Ron Johnson, Mike Wobschall, Vikings.com, and I'm Paul Allen. For all of us here at Winter Park, specifically the TCO Performance Studios, thanks for watching Vikings Game Plan.